Yahoo developed the Yahoo Style Guide, and it's going out to a number of different top journalism schools for a number of reasons. One is because there's a lot of information in the Yahoo Style Guide that's different from other style guides, especially like the AP Style Book. AP is fabulous, but they don't really talk about how to write for the web, how to write headlines that can attract an online audience, how to use SEO, how to do things that are a little bit different that only an online publication would know about. So a lot of these things aren't necessarily taught in journalism schools, and a number of students are going into online publications when they graduate. So by going out and talking to journalism schools, we can impart real-world information, so when we hire these people, they already have these skills that we definitely need. One of the biggest disconnect that students seem to have is what it's really going to be like out there working. What are the demands going to be? And when you're working in an online publication, the deadlines are frenetic. There's really no news close at 11 p.m. Deadlines are all the time. So the demands are different, and the types of things that you need to file can include a podcast, an audio, text. Head, deck, keywords, you know, the body, a whole lot of information that can, you know, go to your editor or go to whoever you have to file it with. It's a different experience, you know, going out there in the real world and trying to understand what exactly are the needs of the publication. Strong writing skills are going to help you no matter what job you have in journalism, because knowing how to write or edit or reorganize somebody else's work, it's a really positive skill to have. But also, you know, besides the strong reporting is multimedia and understanding the technology. So being able to report and take audio and take video and being able to send it back really quickly, you know, edit it down, that's going to be beneficial, especially nowadays. I think being nimble and being able to move into areas where there's need is incredibly important. Who knows where the industry is going now? It seems to be that we're moving into this local and hyper-local area where there's a demand for neighborhood by neighborhood or city or area content, news and information, knowing how to report that, knowing who to report it to, is probably a pretty important skill. So understanding where the trends are, whether it's going into app type applications or combined newspaper and online, we don't really know. It's the media is really burgeoning right now. There's an incredible need for news and information. The business model is in flux in some areas, but the demand for content is definitely there. So knowing how to satisfy that demand is going to be a really critical skill. What we're finding on the journalism side is that students who understand the technological challenges, it's going to benefit them as they explain their work or what their needs are when they go into a newsroom or a publication. To put it conversely, when on the editorial side, if we're building tools, if we're working with somebody who has a computer science degree, let's say, and is putting together some type of content management service for us, and they understand audience development and putting together voice and talking to a specific audience and aggregating them, having that kind of experience on the other side is incredibly helpful to us. So I think that having a computer science, even light background, a computer technology background is beneficial, especially the tools are constantly changing. I do have a 17-year-old, and I am encouraging him to go into journalism because I think that if you have a passion to write and report information, then you're going to be able to find a job. You know, your skills and your passion and your experience are going to transcend the industry, and you will find areas where you can make a living. I don't think it's crystal clear right now on where those areas are going to be. I do believe that the business model is going to develop, but if you really believe in this, if you really think that this is the right thing to do, to go out and give information on whatever platform it is, whether it's in, you know, journalism or PR or any type of other types of communications, if that's really what you want to do, that commitment is going to be obvious in somebody who's going to hire you. What we look for in people when we hire them is online experience. So no matter what level you come in on, whether it's an intern, whether it's a member of the Yahoo Contributor Network, or as an experienced writer, you have to have had online experience. look at, we have audiences that are in the millions depending upon the country and the property. And so you need to have had success writing online and understanding how developing content and writing online is different than writing for a newspaper or for a magazine. There's certain things that you need to know as far as content construction, scalability, making it scannable, understanding SEO, a lot of different things that you wouldn't necessarily do in a print journalism background, where you need that experience in online. There are a lot of new tools that are being developed, whether they're tablets or they're apps or things like that, and a lot of students are being exposed to different technologies that allow them to report in the field using some of these new technologies, or they get fed into these new technologies. And students need to have the agility to be able to move from platform to platform, from demand to demand, so they can fulfill these content, these information needs as they come up. I believe that having a multiplicity of talents and experience is only going to benefit a student. The media landscape is changing so rapidly, we don't really know where things are going to be in the next 2 years or 3 years by the time that they graduate. So having a number of different skills that they can fall back on, so when they go into a job and they have to do something, they said, yeah, oh, I did that in school, or yeah, oh, I practiced this, oh, I did this, let me show you my clips, let me show you this, let me show you my online video, let me show you my podcasts, those types of things. I think having a range of experiences can only be beneficial. It also adds to the student's ability to be able to learn new skills, because technology is just changing so rapidly, and it's going to continue to change. So having that ability to learn and adapt can only be a positive thing. The online experience that students need to have nowadays are a wealth of clips. They need a lot of practice writing. You know, we often talk about this, that in order to become skilled, you need to practice. Well, the good thing about the web is that there are areas that you can practice, and for employers, potential employers, they can see your work. They can see your breadth of experience, the types of things that you've written about, the number of pieces that you've done. It's not like you're going to walk in and say, oh yeah, I've written online, and you have three pieces. You can go up and you say, well, over the last 2 years, I have 75 or I have 100, and I've covered sports, crime, city hall, you know, these types of things, features, fashion, celebs, whatever your interest is, you can show, you can step out, you can explore those, you can really get into it, and then you can show the world, which is really great when you're trying to get a job. Personal blogs are good, but sometimes they're more like diaries. And whereas when you're in a professional or semi-professional environment where you do have an editor that's leading, you can see a potential hirer can see how well this person responds to edits, what type of edits they've had or they do need, or even if, you know, here's the end piece after it has been edited, versus a blog basically is you first person, you know, first or second take. It doesn't have as much polish on it.